I need to know how to avoid pregnancy without protection.
Abstinence is 100% effective unless you have a messianic complex.
I mean without abstinence.
If you have sex during your period, you probably won't get pregnant.
It is the question as to the other times and ways that I want to know.
Let's say the first day of your last period was the first of the month.
And that's the last day I'm sure I could avoid pregnancy without protection.
Your most fertile days would be about 14 days after that, so your most fertile days would be the 12th through the 16th.
That's day 14 plus or minus 2 days.
Those are the days you absolutely must avoid having sex to avoid pregnancy.
That gives me 4 days or so to avoid. What about the other 24?
We already talked about how you probably can't get pregnant the days of your period. The other days you're probably infertile are days 20 through 28.
That's assuming day 1 is when my cycle starts.
Well, yeah. If you're using day 1 as when your cycle starts, the only way not to get pregnant is no sex from days 8 through 19.
That's almost half my cycle.
Then you can start using protection like a condom, female condom, sponges, films and so forth.
I know you can use those methods of protection at any point in the cycle.
And all of those methods don't involve the hormones in birth control that make some women break out, gain weight or have mood swings.
I was more concerned about raising the risk of clots and heart attacks because of the birth control.
Then you're down to barrier methods. Having your tubes tied or only having sex right around your period or during it to not get pregnant.
I've heard there were other ways.
Do you know the joke about how there is an app for that?
I know it seems like there is an app for everything today.
There are apps for tracking your most and least fertile days, and you can use the natural family planning applications to know when not to have sex. These are really useful if your period varies or you don't want to keep track of it on paper.
An app would be a lot less weird than trying to figure out cervical mucus. Or having to explain what I'm tracking on my calendar.
By the time you see the changes in cervical mucus to clear and watery, you are already into the fertile period. So only use that to know the best time to have sex to get pregnant.
Glad I know now.
Some women track their fertility using the temperature method, but again, by the time that spikes, you're too late to prevent pregnancy if you had sex the night before.
I don't like the temperature method because getting up to get the thermometer can raise the body temperature too much, and staying warm and snug in bed messes it up too. Why not the withdrawal method?
If you can't trust a guy to use a condom during your fertile time to prevent pregnancy, do you trust him to withdraw at the height of passion to prevent pregnancy?
Then not so fertile tracking app it is.